7/12 minus 2/15 plus 5/18. We now have three fractions with three different denominators. We need to find the least common denominator of all three denominators. So we need to find the least common multiple of 18, 15, and 12. It's often easier to make a list of the largest number first. So I'm going to start with a list of 18. I'm going to make a list of the multiples of 18. Because if you make a list of the larger number first, then it's easier to see if the smaller number will go into those numbers. So I'm going to start with 18. So we have 18, 36, 54, 72, and 90. Now I'm going to stop right here at 90. Not because 90 is my least common multiple, but I'm planning ahead for the list of the multiples of the other numbers. 15 ends in a 5. That means that all the multiples of 15 are going to end in 0 or 5. So my least common multiple of all three of these numbers has to end in a 0 or 5 in order for 15 to work. Now, I know 90 doesn't work because 12 does not go evenly into 90. 90 will not be in the list of multiples of 12. But I'm going to keep going and see what the next number is that I get that ends in a 0. Okay, I see 180 is in my list. Let's check the list of 15 and see if 180 falls in that list. Yep, 180 falls in the list of the multiples of 15. Now notice 90 is also in the list, but remember it has to be a multiple of all three numbers, and 90 will not be in the list of multiples for 12. Let's check 12 and make sure 180 is in the list of multiples of 12. And there we have it. 180 is the least common multiple of 18, 15, and 12. Now we have to figure out how many times each number got multiplied to get us 180, or we have to figure out what we need to multiply each number by in order to get 180. So for 18, we had to do 18 times 10 because it was the 10th number in the list. 15 is 15 times 12 because it was the 12th number in the list. And 12 is the for 12, 180 is the 15th number in the list, so we're going to have to multiply by 15. Let's start writing our equivalent fractions. 7 over 12 is going to get multiplied by 15 over 15 to become 105 over 180. 2 over 15 is going to get multiplied by 12 over 12 to become 24 over 180. And 5/18 will get multiplied by 10 over 10 for 50 over 180. So our original problem was 7/12 minus 2/15 plus 5/18, which is going to be written as 105 over 180 minus 24 over 180 plus 50 over 180. Now that we have the same denominator, we can combine the numerators. This becomes 105 minus 24 plus 50 all over 180 for a final answer of 131 over 180.